Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of this chapter. Today I am going to teach you multiplication and division properties of rational numbers. Because in previous class we already discussed about rational numbers and its addition and subtraction properties. So today we talk about these two. But what are these properties? Because these properties are also same as we studied in the previous class, but the only difference is the symbol. So have you remembered? Let's recall. These properties are closure, associative, commutative, existence of inverse, and existence of identity. Let's start with the closure property of multiplication. According to these properties, if we multiplied two different rational number, then the result is also a rational number. Look at this example. Here we take two different rational number, 5 by 9 and 2 by 9, and we multiplied them. We get 10 upon 81, which is also a rational number. What is rational number? A number which can be written in the form of P upon Q, where Q not equal to the 0, and P and Q belongs to the integers, is known as a rational numbers. Commutative property. Multiplication of rational number is also commutative, because if you multiply two rational number in any order, you always get the same result. Look at this example. If you multiplied 5 by 9 into 2 by 9, you get 10 upon 81. But in second line, if we change the order of multiplication, we always get the same result. Therefore, commutative property is true for multiplication. Associative property. It is also true for multiplication, because if you multiply three different rational number in any order, you always get the same result. Look at this. Here we take three different rational number, 2 by 9, 4 by 9 and 1 by 9. In first line, we firstly multiplied 4 by 9 and 1 by 9. Then we multiplied 2 by 9. We get 8 by 7 to 9. But in second line, the numbers are same, but we change the order of multiplication. But in last, we also get the same result. Therefore, associative property is true for multiplication. Multiplicative identity. One is the multiplicative identity, because if you multiplied any rational number with 1, you always get the same rational number itself. For example, you take any numbers like 1 by 3, 7 by 8, as you wish, and multiplied it by 1, you always get the same result. Look at this example. Here we multiplied 5 by 7 into 1, we get the result 5 by 7. Fifth one is multiplication by 0. Every numbers, every rational numbers, integer, whole numbers, multiplied with 0 always gives the result 0. If you multiply 2 by 3 into 0, you get the result 0. If you multiply 7 by 8 into 0, you get the result 0. That is, any numbers, any real numbers you multiplied with 0, you always get the result 0. Next one is multiplicative inverse or reciprocal. Inverse or reciprocal means just reverse of the given number. If the given number is 2 by 3, its inverse is 3 by 2. If the given number is 7 by 8, its inverse or reciprocal is 8 by 7. Okay? So according to this property, for every rational number A by B, there exists a rational number C by D such that the multiplication of both numbers are equal to the 1. For example, if you multiply 2 by 3 into 3 by 2, what you get? You always get the result 1. Okay? So the reciprocal of 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. The reciprocal of 1 by 3 is 3. The reciprocal of 3 is 1 by 3. The reciprocal of 1 is 1. But the reciprocal of 0 is undefined, because 0 can't be written in the denominator. Next is division. Closure property for division. Closure property is also true for division, but under the condition. The condition is that divisor not equal to the zero. Look at here. If we divide A by B by C by D, when C by D not equal to the zero, then the result is also a rational number. For example, if you divide 2 by 3 by 1 by 3, we get the result 2, which is also a rational number. Okay. Commutative property. Division of rational number is not commutative, because if you divide two different rational number in different order, you always get the different result. Look at this example. Here, firstly, we divide 2 by 3 by 1 by 3, then we get 2. But when we change the order of divisor, we get the result 1 by 2. Therefore, commutative property is not true for division. Third one is associative. Associative property is also not true for division, because if you divide three different rational number in different order, you always get the different result. Look at this example. Here we take three different rational number, 2 by 9, 4 by 9 and 1 by 9. In first case, we firstly divide 4 by 9 by 1 by 9, we get 4. Then we divide 2 by 9 by 4, we get 1 upon 18. But in second case, we firstly divide 2 by 9 by 4 by 9, we get 1 by 2. Then we divide 1 by 2 by 1 by 9, we get 9 by 2. In both cases, the results are not same. Therefore, associative property is not true for division. Okay, student, that's all for today. In next class, we will discuss about next topic of this chapter. Till then, stay at home and also complete your assignment. Thank you. Have a nice day.